So if you're like me and live in databases, you are going to need this one little trick to navigate around your Notion databases, your Notion space a little more easily. This was before back buttons, before buttons were a thing in Notion. I used to create my own back buttons in my Notion spaces with callout boxes and hyperlinking. So I'm going to show you some ways today to create back buttons or navigation buttons within Notion using the new button template, the new button block, as well as a callout block and hyperlinking.
Okay, so you have your meeting notes or whatever it is, because you live in databases just like I do, and you're clicking through each page and you want to get from inside a page back to where you just came from, where your database lives. Now, if you look at this breadcrumb here, because this is a dashboard within like in a database in another page, this breadcrumb looks crazy, right? Too many clicks. So I created a back button using my callout boxes in Notion. So if we were to get out of here, that's one click, that's two click. Alternatively, it would have been the breadcrumb and then clicking to this page in meeting notes that we have everything in. So how I create this is create your callout box. And for like, if you're like ADHD, like me, if you have like ADHD or you just get distracted very easily, a lot of people get like brain fog and stuff now with long COVID. If you get distracted like really easily, this is a great way to like not get as distracted and confused and forget where it is you're going. If you're in here and you just want to get to meeting notes, it's one click, not several, and you don't have to think about it too much. You just label it as clear as possible, right? So we're going to create a callout box. So /callout. And you're going to name it whatever you want. Back to meetings. Again, if you label this very clearly, it's going to be easier for you to like navigate where it is you're going and not get distracted. So how I do this is I've created an anchor within this page to direct that hyperlink to. So I have this divider here. You probably didn't notice it before. It's very unobtrusive. You copy link to the block, right? And then you highlight and then copy paste and add your hyperlink to this. So now when you click this hyperlink, it takes you to where that anchor block is, and not anywhere else in the page. If you have a pretty long page, like I do in some of my pages in my Notion spaces, I have some pretty long pages. So if you have a long page, linking to an anchor block, as I call it, would make it easier, again, for you not to get distracted, not for you to forget where you're going, not for you to forget, you know, just to keep on track with where you're going. And this way, you can also have multiple. If your page is pretty long, you can anchor multiple. You can link multiple blocks. Now, I came up with this before I had, before Notion came out with their button blocks. So the button blocks, you can do the same thing. Well, similar as it will. /button. But the buttons direct to a page and not a link. So that's the only thing with the button blocks. I love button blocks. Love, 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 love. But sometimes I want to direct to an anchor instead of the block itself, the page itself. So if you go to open page and select the page that we want to go to in full page, back to meetings page. This is going to take us directly to the top of the page. So no matter how long this page is, and I'll show you, just creating a bunch of text blocks here. Empty text blocks. No matter where this, how long this page is, this button is going to take you directly to the top of the page. But if we have an anchor block like this, divider block, or alternatively, let's make one of these text blocks a colored text block. And we're going to copy the link to that block. Scroll all the way back up. And we're going to create a new callout block, duplicate, bottom of the page. Let's call it that because that's where we're going to be, bottom of the page. And let's do, let's make an emoji, so an icon to differentiate the two. If we click this one, we are going to go down to the bottom of the page where this block is, this divider is. And we're at the bottom. So I'm going to show you again. Let's do that again. Scroll up to the top. This is what the top of the page looks like. And actually, let's create another page. So our divider link goes to the top of the page. So we're going back to meetings. Our divider link goes to that anchor, that top of the page, wherever that anchor is. So our anchor is closer to the top. It's taking us to the top of the page, or as close as possible. This other one, with the bottom of the page, our colored text block is taking us, because it's an anchor, it's taking us exactly to where that block is. So we are at the bottom of this page, down all the way, well, not all the way down to the bottom, but we are not at the top as we are with this other link. So those are two ways that you can create navigation in your Notion space. And these are two ways that I use navigating my Notion space to keep my neurodivergent brain on track, in line, every time I have something to do in Notion. So try these out. Let me know in the comments if you've tried them, and if you need any help implementing either of these two ways to navigate your Notion space.